Hey friends, it's Devin here with Make Anything. Happy New Year's, first of all. In my last video, I launched a competition where I'm asking you to create some unique artworks using these transforming auxetic tiles. And I printed these tiles using the Multipass Multicolor technique, which lets us get more than one color out of a single extruder 3D printer. I've used this technique for plenty of projects, and I've shared some tutorials on doing this in Simplify 3D and Cura, but nowadays I'm mostly using Prusa Slicer, so I thought I'd create a tutorial on how to do this in Prusa Slicer as well. So in this video, I'll be sharing my current process for creating these multi-pass multicolor prints in Prusa Slicer so that you can do so as well and join that competition while there's still time. Anyways, I'm gonna keep it simple, so let's get right into it. Here is the model we'll print today. It's a phone case with this simple two-color graphic of Snell the Snail. The graphics are just straight 0.4mm extrusions, which are also cut out of the case, so there's no overlap, and I've saved each color as a separate STL file. But we're gonna focus on slicing, so let's bring this into Prusa Slicer. I'll start by adding one of the parts first. Then, instead of simply importing the rest, we're going to go to this part list and right-click on the first part, go down to Add Part, and select Load. Add the remaining parts from there, and that'll make sure that they're all perfectly aligned. If your printer has a leveling probe, you may have to move the part to avoid the probe when printing consecutive colors. So, as an example, I'll move the print to avoid the center of the print bed here, where a BL touch might probe the print bed. To print each part separately, we need to select the group from this list again, right-click and go to Split and select Two Objects. Now we can right-click these eye icons to disable individual parts and leave us with just the first part active. Now, when we click Slice, Prusa Slicer will ignore the other parts. For this first part, we don't need to change our default settings much. If you like using a skirt, you may need to increase the distance from the part so it won't interfere with the next colors, or you can just remove the skirt between prints. Also, since our graphics are 0.4 millimeters tall, it's ideal if the first and second layers add up to a total of 0.4 millimeter height. It's not totally essential, but it helps keep things clean, so we'll change the initial layer height to 0.24 millimeters, so the first two layers end up being exactly 0.4 millimeters tall. Great, now we can slice this up, and I'll save the G-code to my micro SD card. Now let's select the second color to slice. We don't need to change too much, except we do want to make sure that the printer nozzle won't run into the first color that's already printed. I always forget where the Z lift option is, so I'll just use the handy search bar here and find this travel lift height setting. Okay, so here it is under the printer extruder settings. So this needs to be at least 0.4 millimeters to avoid the last color, but I'll make it 0.6 to ensure that it completely clears the print. We can also change this setting to 0.6 as well, because after that height, we don't need the extruder to lift anymore. I've made one mistake here, but you'll see that in a bit. For now, I exported that second color to another G-code file. Now we can slice the final color, which is also the remainder of the print. We don't really need to change anything else here, but I will set the infill to 100% just to make sure that this phone case is strong. And we'll go ahead and make sure the slicing looks good before exporting that final G-code file. Now it's off to my Soval SV01, which I'll be using to print this out. First, I'm gonna clean off the bed with isopropyl alcohol, trying to make sure that there aren't any bits of filament left over from other prints that would transfer to the surface of this print, because our color graphics are all gonna be happening on this bottom face. Now I can load up my first color, and since these first colors use very little filament, I can use up this tiny bit of green I have left. Now let's select the first file in the print menu and get printing. Hopefully the printer is well tuned and the first layers go down nicely. Each color here will only take a few minutes, so I'm gonna stand around until that's done. And the shell looks good, so let's load up some light blue PLA for the next part. I'll remove the skirt left from the first print and start print number two. This is where I noticed my mistake, because the skirt from this print doesn't entirely avoid the first color. Whoops. Well, we'll see if we can clean that up after this print. If you look closely, you can see the Z-lift here as the nozzle travels across the print. All right, here's color number two finished up, and I'm just gonna use my clippers and X-Acto knife to clean up that skirt as well as I can. I should have used a much larger skirt offset, or just turned off the skirt setting altogether for this color. But it looks like it'll work out. So let's swap out to our last filament and run the print for our final color. As before, this print should avoid the first two colors, but after the first two layers, it will actually print on top of everything and finish up the entire phone case. A few hours later, and we can reveal the result. All right, this phone case ended up looking pretty good, despite a slight fumble with the brim on the second color. Hopefully you can learn from my mistakes, as well as from everything that works for me. So this is my current technique for doing multi-pass multicolor prints like this. I think it would be very cool if someone eventually wrote a script or an add-on for a slicer that lets you automate this process a bit more. It is possible to do this all within a single G-code file and have filament color swaps programmed in and whatnot. But what I share today is how I actually pull off this technique. So that was the point of this video. Anyways, that's multi-pass, multicolor 3D printing on a single extruder printer. I think it's a really cool, very powerful technique. So hopefully y'all learned something from this. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. I'll answer what I can. If you're stoked on this stuff, give me a like, subscribe if you're not already following the channel, and make sure you join that auxetic tile competition before the end of January. There's a 3D printer and gift cards to Matter Hackers and 3D Jake on the line, so hopefully that's something to get excited about, or just more multicolor prints in general. Anyways, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'll see you in the next one. Take care. And as always, stay inspired.